Hello, I'm Dr. Elisha Teo, and I'm a researcher with the ENOS Project and Aalborg University Copenhagen. In my work, I explore education in open science, citizen science, and open innovation activities. They are increasingly mainstream as they support equitable quality education and lifelong learning. As relatively new open tools, resources, and pedagogies are being introduced, it is important that their implementation are carefully designed.
Hi, I'm Svenja Neuchel from the Learning Technologies Research Group at RWTH Aachen University. Nowadays, digitalization in areas of daily life possesses major challenges, especially for senior citizens. They often lack the digital competences to interact in the digital world without problems. Therefore, I would like to introduce InfoBits to you. It is an Origin mobile Android application for tablets, which in addition to the basics of using mobile devices, provides computer science content in four modules.
My name is Patricia Kruijt, and I'm a teacher, educator and researcher at the Amsterdam University of Applied Sciences in the Netherlands. In a poster, we present an educational instrument that will promote development of scientific literacy in primary school students. We discuss the design of the instrument and results of a small-scale effect study. The study relates to the conference by using interactive features to support learning.
Hi everyone, I'm Mireille Thiriez. I'm a PhD student at the University of Bonn and a research assistant at Fraunhofer Institute in Germany. I'm working on topics related to semantic web, open education and web accessibility. Due to the large number of open educational resources that are available over the internet, we propose a set of matrices to help evaluate the quality of such resources. These matrices should help authors to create high-quality content. We have implemented some of these matrices in our OpenCourseWare system, SlideWiki, and we would like to share the results with you.
My name is Tommy and I'm a PhD student from Dresden, Germany. In our poster, we present the adoption of an approach called Scenario Tailored Audience Response System, or in short STARS, to integrate interactive activities in livestream lectures. This is done by creating customized workflows using a Graphica editor. We visualize this on the teaching method peer instruction, in which both concept tests and peer discussion are executed in the online environment. Using STARS allows lecturers to support their individual teaching scenarios and thus improves the quality of education.